Third. Base.
For UFO, then we put it out there. I do have some breaking news that's just coming in. We have permission granted from Gene Mad. And you're going to be seeing this on Third Phase of Moon. We're going to be posting this video right after this radio show. Stay tuned for that. And we're going to be replaying this. I wanted to give Gene Mad credit. He captured this, and he calls it the Valley of UFOs. Willamette Valley UFOs. We'll find out exactly where that is. But he takes a lot of pictures, and he took 600 shots. And he calls this an epic show. Tag it, you're it. Basically, these UFOs are just like chasing each other around. He says some of these could be planes, but then they're not flashing. He's not exactly sure. He says it's an epic show nonetheless. So we're going to share these incredible 600 shots caught over a valley. And it's pretty amazing. Beautiful shots. Thanks for sharing that. Incredible imagery. Third Phase of Moon live, taking your calls from around the world. Blake Cousins here. The number to call in is 347-934-0378. Going live right now. We just broke some incredible imagery coming in all the way from Mexico. The Colima volcano is basically a hotspot for the past 4 years of strange anomalies showing up in webcams that are tracked on this volcano following its eruption patterns. And what people are saying, or what's captured in these, are UFOs, and some of them even come in triangular shapes. And we are showcasing this right now in Third Phase of Moon. We're going to be showing this on the YouTube channel, Third Phase. We're taking your calls from around the world. We want people to share their experiences, share any insight on what they think the UFO phenomenon is. Everybody, this is going to be the Third Phase of Moon Radio. Now let's get to it. Let's get to the first caller that's been holding on for a while. We got Rick from Stone Creek, Canada. Welcome to the show, Rick.
Hi, Blake. How you doing today?
Hey, doing pretty good. We just put some – it's been kind of slow this week. Everything kind of settled down over there in Canada as far as new information coming in on that crash. And there hasn't been much on UFOs, and then all of a sudden I got this email of these UFOs over the volcano. I found quite fascinating, so we put that up right now, but doing pretty good. Happy and excited about the radio show tonight. What's going on over there in Canada? Any updates of the crash?
Well, see, no updates on it. I've been getting all my information from you. But anyways, the thing is, we see the UFOs. The thing is, who is flying it? Is it one of our militaries, or is it an extraterrestrial? That's a question we always have in mind. Another big question is why, Blake? I hear you trying so hard to get answers, and they're just not giving you any answers. Either they don't know, or they've been told not to talk. My guess is they've been told not to talk. What do you think on that one?
Hey, thanks for calling in, Rick. Fair question. You know, we're getting people from that end claiming that it's a military cover-up, and they've seen the flying saucer themselves, and they've been told to keep their mouth shut by the military over there. And then other people, and a lot of websites are claiming, hey, it's just a hoax. It's all a big setup. And they're pretty much going along with the military story. And, hey, if you're a ufologist and you think you believe everything that the military tells you, then go right ahead and believe what you want. I still think something went down big time over there, and some people are saying, hey, it's an airplane crash and a simulated one at that. They've still not yet shown any proof whatsoever of that event happening, and their story keeps changing. So I'm still thinking this is the biggest thing since 1947. We're not getting answers from there because, you know, the military might's pretty powerful, and they might not want to, you know, obviously, if they have a UFO in their possession and it went down, you know, in most cases, they are going to cover this up and not get it out. I'm not taking the military's word for it at the moment.
Well, that's good. No, anyways, Blake, it's like I noticed that you're starting to wonder if us Canadians our disclosure or not. And many of us are, like myself, but there are too many that are not. And it's like, we're behind you, Blake, in what you're trying to do. And this could be it. This could be the big one. This could be the leak event, the one that we've been waiting for that gets it so it can't be covered up anymore. This could be the disclosure itself.
Absolutely. What I find interesting is that some of these people out there, these other websites, I'm not going to name them, but they're supposed to be out there, you know, following and trying to explore that we're not alone in the universe, but then they go ahead and say this is a hoax and it's a big setup, and they really have no proof to state that claim. We have a lot more proof stating that it is a real event from people's testimony right here on Third Phase of the Moon, people's sending us pictures of a military exercise, what have you. We call it a UFO recovery, and then weird photographs of what appears to be maybe a pyramidal shape lodged in a frozen lake. That's more proof than taking the military's word, and then their story keeps changing, and then people are, you know, it amazes me that these UFO experts out there are claiming that this one is a hoax for some odd reason. I don't know why they wouldn't jump on over it, all over it. What's your thoughts?
Well, I don't think it's a hoax myself. I think it's a cover-up. With the government, you got to know how the power structure is with the government, because everything's run by the Freemasons. They're the backbone behind the secret power of the structure, and backed up by Buckingham Palace. And the government is not run by offices; it's run by corporations. They merge their assets and become a lobbying group. And then over top of that, it's run by the program, and the program itself is not human. That is run by extraterrestrials. I've done extensive research on this subject, and I keep on going into it deeper and deeper. And the deeper I go, the more I know I don't know, if that makes any sense. But anyways, that's why they're not telling you, because the enemy is in our own backyard. You don't even know who it is. It's your uncle. It's your grandfather. It's your next-door neighbor. So that's why you're not getting any answers.
You know, it is. It gets quite frustrating at times when you are trying to seek the truth and find out what's going on, and then you kind of come up against a stone wall, and you just can't get any further into what you're trying to find out, try to find out the truth. And I think there is a media cap. They've scuttled this very well, and now it's pretty much a dead story. But in Third Phase of the Moon, we're going to keep following this. I got a feeling as things maybe quiet down over there, and maybe some of the people from the reservation, the Jackhead Reservation, might feel more comfortable about sharing what really went down in Manitoba. And I'm thinking that, you know, we might haven't seen anything yet. You said you've been doing a lot of research. Tell me, what got you started into the research? Have you witnessed the UFO for yourself, Rick?
Well, it just started going for the truth, because you're finding out that we're living in, the lie is the norm. And that's just not good. So you start digging into the truth. And the deeper you go, it just gets off into so many different categories. So you just keep on going deeper and deeper. And the first thing, the truth will make you angry. And then it will set you free. But you got to, first of all, you got to accept, like, there's a lot of truths that I found that really kind of shook me up. And it takes a lot of accepting to do, to keep on going deeper. So, yeah, that's what I've been doing.
Wow, excellent work. You keep looking for the truth. And maybe one of these days, I think we've already found a lot of truth on Third Phase of the Moon. I think we've had, you know, we've already seen extraterrestrial vehicles. They're in there. The videos on Third Phase of the Moon, you know, some of them are questionable. Obviously, there are some that have slipped through the cracks, but in my opinion, I believe we've already seen extraterrestrial craft on third phase of the moon. While the phone lines are building up, let's get to it right now. Let's get to area code 706. Thanks for waiting. Tell us your name. Where are you calling from?
My name is Heath Miller. I'm from Commerce, Georgia.
Hey, Steve, welcome to the show. What's going on over there in Georgia?
Well, you know, as a couple weeks ago, we had an ice over.
Absolutely. Record-breaking sub-zero temperatures over there.
Oh, and I have a story to tell you.
Let's hear it, man. We're live, Third Phase of Moon Radio. Steve's got a story to share. Go ahead.
Well, after the 30 minutes when the power went out, we go outside and we see these flashing lights in the sky. And they're going from blue to red to green to orange to purple with no sound whatsoever.
Wow, what do you think it was, Steve?
I have no idea because it was like right in the middle of the woods.
You know what drones look like, right? Kind of drone characteristics. A lot of people mistake nowadays UFOs for drones, and sometimes the green and red.
It fluidly changed color, like fluidly, like almost like a morph.
Wow, what made you go outside right after the power went out?
Excuse me, I'm kind of broke up a little bit. Say that again.
Yeah, Steve, what compelled you to go outside? You know, it's super cold over there at that time when the power went out to, witness this.
Well, I just saw it out my window. And then I went outside to go look at it. I was like, wow, that doesn't usually happen here.
Steve, can you tell us exactly what location this occurred in again?
It came in Commerce, Georgia.
Hey, thanks for sharing, Steve. If anybody in the area maybe saw something that Steve saw during this power outage, hey, contact Third Phase of the Moon, share it, reach out, videos. The best way to send videos to Third Phase of the Moon is go to our About page, and it describes what you need to do. Basically, upload your UFO video to YouTube, and my contact is in the About page, and then just copy-paste the link. And, if we find it compelling enough that we believe that it could be extraterrestrial, definitely you'll hear from us back, and we'll want to share your video to the world. That's what we do at Third Phase of Moon. Let's get to another caller right now. Area code 831. Thanks for holding. You're live, Third Phase of Moon. Tell us your name. Where are you calling from?
Hey, Blake. That's Drew.
Hey, Drew. Where are you calling from, Drew?
I'm over in Capitola.
Capitola?
California. Yeah.
What's going over there in Capitola, California?
I was just going to ask you a question, then I can just keep listening if that's cool. You know, it was about the Canadian thing that happened. And didn't you say you had a photo that you couldn't release because you didn't get permission? I was just curious what happened with that. That was the question.
Absolutely. Well, you know, the photo got leaked out there. People chose to run with the photograph, and we shared that in an episode last week, saying the photo's leaked, and we have a link to our Facebook of the photograph that somebody posted on our Facebook. So it's out there, and you should go back to maybe a few episodes on Third Phase of the Moon and look up leaked photo from Canada, and the link will take you to our Facebook. Or just, join us on Facebook, and the photo's there as well. You know, in certain cases, we'd like to share as much as we possibly can, but our number one rule is if we don't have permission from the person that shot it, we really can't showcase it. That's why we really implore people to share their videos and reach out to us. And then there's other people that'll basically just steal the video or steal the photograph and put it up, and that's what's been done on this. I hope the guy that comes out, hey, maybe he's going to claim rights to it. But I'm glad it got out, and it is out. It looked like Brent's. Did you get to see the artist's rendition that I remember that, Brent. Yeah, I'd like for you to see that video, the photograph on Facebook that's been leaked, and compare it to that. It's quite similar. So I hope that answers your question there.
Oh, did you see the one? This is just regarding it, and it's just, did you see the one that was on another site that, you know, you probably know about? And it looked more like a disc than a triangle. So I wasn't sure, like, which one is actually the one that you saw or had, you know. Sometimes it's hard to tell.
Let me tell you, that one famous photograph that's been going around is not, that's a doctored photograph. It had nothing to do with the leak photograph. That was basically what you just call clickbait. And somebody, there was a clickbait thumbnail that was produced by, you know. So, yeah, that's not the photograph that has been leaked. That was just an outright clear Photoshop. Some people are claiming, hey, Blake, take a look at this photograph. It's the UFO disc that crashed in the lake, and they're sending me this photograph. And let me tell you, that's not the one. So definitely I could answer that question as well. In my opinion, that's a doctored photograph. Let's put it that way.
Yeah, I mean, I like the illustration that was done was really nice, and it's totally different. You said it was kind of like the top of a cruise line ship or something, you know, like that. And there had been some sightings of a similar thing that kind of looked, you know, drone-ish maybe, but it kind of went around and looked sort of like the top, and it was a pyramid shape, the top of a yacht, you know, it looked like kind of those lines where the windows are and diamond shape or something. Anyway, that's all.
Absolutely.
I just wondered.
Yeah, once you see the photograph, you'll understand. And it's out there on the net, so just look up leaked UFO photograph and you'll find it. And, yeah, definitely compare it to Brent's. You know, he did that. It took him about 10 minutes, maybe about no more than 10 minutes to complete that artist rendition of what we were looking at. And, yeah, hopefully we can get the man himself that shot that. You know, that's the whole important thing, is speaking to the eyewitnesses for these events instead of just, you know, like a lot of people just kind of run with the story and not give credit where credit's due. And I think that's why people like Third Phase of the Moon, because people get their credit where credit's due, and that's the most important thing.
Yeah, you guys seem really legit about all that. That's cool.
Hey, Drew, thanks for calling in, man. I got to get to the callers. Appreciate you asking the questions.
Yep, my pleasure.
Okay, stick around.
That's a good one.
Hey, thanks, Drew. Appreciate it. Let's get to another caller standing by, area code 423. Tell us your name. Where are you calling from?
My name is Emmanuel Williams, and I'm calling from Chattanooga, Tennessee.
Hey, Emmanuel. How's it going?
Oh, man. I've had some strange things that happened to me, and I don't know if it was because of me. If something had happened to me, I had seen this like neonish blue light one day off into the woods. I was walking from my grandmama's house off the street, but off to the left of me, deep off into the woods, it was like a creek area back there. I seen this like neonish blue light. It was like a blue that I never seen before, you know. So after that, I started having these like different type of like voices telling me like if something like happens, right, or telling me to get my phone and video this guy. So as I've been doing this, I've been catching things in the sky, and I know they're not airplanes. They're not airplanes, okay? They're shaped like pyramids, but they're, you can't see the full shape of a pyramid. You just see three lights in the sky, and they're twirling, spinning back and forward, flipping up and down. I have a video of the footage that I recorded from the phone, and I have a picture of them just sitting still. I tried to send it to you on through my Facebook page. I tried to send you the video footage from my Facebook page, but I'm just wondering if the voices I hear majority of the time I think I'd be passed out, but when I wake up, I remember something telling me to do this and do that, and at this point in time, I've been like kind of like down, feeling bad, right? But these things tell me to do this or do that, and the outcome is like, okay, I make money today, now I'm happy. Or it tells me someone stole your phone. This is who stole the phone. You need to go back and tell the people to give you your phone. And I don't know where that voice has come from, because majority of the time I've been like sitting in my car. I'll be sitting in my car, and next thing I know, I pass out. And then I don't know if I see the vision of what the voice is coming from, but it's kind of strange. And I don't want to seem crazy. I think that it was spaceships coming down here.
Hey, Manuel, you're not crazy. You're not alone. People, telecommunication with extraterrestrial beings has been going on for thousands of years, and people hear these voices in their heads. You know, yeah, there's schizophrenia and, you know, people that have health issues, very mentally, hearing things, it could mess with a person's brain. As long as they're not thoughts of hurting anybody or anything like that, but trying to, if you hear a communication or a goal, something to do positive, maybe it's coming from them. I'm not exactly sure. Let me ask you.
See what else I see when I look in the sky. When I look in the sky, I see... like real tiny rays of light, just like sprinkles. It looks like pixie dust in the sky. I see that. Then plus I see like little tiny numbers, like just basically just strolling back and forth. Zeros, ones. And a couple of letters.
But hey, you know what, Emmanuel? Let me see those videos. Go to Third Phase of Moon YouTube. Go to the About page. My contact information is there. Then upload your video to YouTube. Copy paste the link. We'll be keeping in touch, Emmanuel. Stand by. We got to get to callers right now. They're building up right here at Third Phase. We want to get to everybody. Thanks for waiting, everybody online. We'll try to get everybody's testimony in, questions. The number to call in is 347. That again, 347-934-0378. Let's get to the next caller, Third Phase of Moon Live. Area code 224, you're live, Third Phase of Moon. Welcome.
Hey, what's up, man?
Hey, doing pretty good. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
My name is Peter. I'm calling from Chicago area.
Hey Pete, how's the Windy City?
Man, cold, it's cold, but it's supposed to get warmer next week. I had a few things. I had a few questions actually. I did want to talk about one thing I saw one time when I was working the night shift, and it was pretty strange. I was just smoking a cigarette outside, like outside a movie theater, cleaning. It was like probably like 3 a.m. cleaning the carpets there, and I just wanted to ask and. I've tried looking up videos from what I saw. Like I saw it almost looked like a barrel-shaped UFO flying like above the train tracks, but like kind of in the distance. It was very dark, so you could only kind of see the silhouette. By the time I went in to call my partner, it was already gone. And I just wanted to see if anybody ever seen on, you know, anywhere out there, like heard of like any kind of barrel-shaped UFOs. If you could just ask some people around.
Well, yeah, the Nazi bell's very famous. Leaked photographs from the time apparently showcases of what looks to be reverse-engineered technology, and it was shaped like a bell. And then there's other videos that have been submitted right here. Even Joaquin from Tucson, Arizona, if I'm not mistaken, sent us some incredible video right after a microburst. Heavy weather came down right over his trailer park, and then a barrel-shaped. He went outside to check out, look at the damage in the area, and then managed to capture this incredibly cylindrical shape. But it was weird. Let's just put it that way. These birds started like migrate around it, and we'll post this up on our Third Phase of Moon Radio or our YouTube channel tomorrow, so you can take a look at this video from Tucson. Not sure what it could have been, but you know, Chicago is kind of there's been sightings over there in the past, even at O'Hare Airport. That lasted for a few minutes right there, and a lot of people saw it. Left a hole in the clouds.
I was gonna say I actually live like right by O'Hare in a town called Bensonville, so I'm like looking my balcony faces like O'Hare, constantly looking outside all the time, seeing it. And I've seen like some strange like a light, but it could have been a star that was like twinkling. And I heard about gases passing through the sky, so it could really like give it a crazy effect. But I'm always looking out there, man.
Absolutely. You got to keep looking. If anybody in the Flash chat has seen a barrel-shaped UFO or have any idea what it could a barrel-shaped UFO represent, say it in the chat, call in, and leave it in the comments when he posts this up on Third Phase of the Moon. I'm sure we'll get some answers. You know, I don't have all the answers. I'm just trying to share the information that comes into us. But, hey, thanks for sharing your sighting.
One more thing, man. I've been, like, trying to check your Facebook. I don't know if, like, what happened, if it's, like, blocked or something, but, like, the last post we've had was since, it was, like, 2013. I don't know if something got blocked on the Facebook. I've just been checking, and I wanted to, like, check up on some new stuff.
Absolutely. You know, we have our Facebook, and you should go to our About page, again, on Third Phase of the Moon. And if you go to the – because once you hit over 5,000 friends, then they switch you into this whole other aspect.
Oh, really? Is that
I didn't like the way that went down, but Facebook has this policy. Once you reach over 5,000, then you have to change it up. Otherwise, you're locked in and nobody else could get in. So basically everybody becomes – a follower afterwards, but we're still posting every day to our Facebook. So it's there. It's under Blake Cousins. It's facebook.com/blake.cousins.3, but I'll put it in the chat. Okay. And then again, you just go to the About page and then just it'll be there. I just put it in the Flash chat. Yeah. Hey, thanks for the heads up. I'm sure there's some confusion.
Thank you. Yeah. Thanks you, man.
Yeah, we're up to, I think, about 7,000 followers now, so we've gained a couple thousand more as this changed up. But, you know, Pete, you keep your eyes on the skies because that's what it's all about, and have your camera ready, all right, and keep in touch.
Exactly, man. Thank you very much.
All right, let's get to some other callers. This has been an incredible radio show. We got callers calling in from around the country, and people are excited. People want to find out the truth. 925, you're live, Third Phase of the Moon. Tell us your name. Where are you calling from?
Oh, hey, it's John from Livermore, California. So,
hey, John.
Yeah, thank you, guys. Hey, thanks for the work you guys are doing, and we're not all crazy, you know. What I seen years ago, I really sort of think I was crazy for a while.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, and, you know, when you bring it up to anybody, that's the first thing they think is, you know, you've been smoking pot or you're drinking or you're just plain crazy. But So I got to tell you, my wife and I, we'd go camping all the time, and we'd go up to Tahoe Forest up off Highway 50, place called Loon Lake, one of the last reservoirs way up there in the mountains. So I'm a little nervous. It's about 35 miles off of Highway 50 in the Crystal Recreation Basin area up there, wilderness area. And so, you know, this was November the 2nd. This is about 23 years ago. It was about 10 o'clock at night. My wife and I were on the top bunk of our cab over, and we're just shooting a light out the window, and we started noticing things moving in and out of the bushes. But, you know, it was pitch black up there. You couldn't see 5 feet in front of you, even with the flashlight out the window, you know. And then so I was like, well, that's kind of weird. It was like, well, were these animals out there or what? And then a few minutes later, my wife looks back out, and she goes, oh, look, there's helicopters up there. And I was like, helicopters? And I look out the window, and there's these red lights up on the mountain range, and they're flying around like at a blink of an eye and then stopping real quick, and then they would drop down into the tree line. And there was a bunch of them doing this, and I was looking out the window, like, and they're all going back and forth, and these things are moving like traveling like airplanes don't, and they're a solid red light. Now, of course, you know, there's things going on in between there. It's like I'm playing off like it's no big deal, but I know it's not a helicopter. And eventually I look out the other window of our camper, and there's these small globe lights about the size of, half the size of a soccer ball. And they're glowing, but not really portraying a light, pitching a light out. It's like they're glowing from within. And I look around, and these things are all around us, around the face of the dam, and it's a rock and earth dam, so it's like they're moving around the rocks and in between the cracks and up and down. I look over, they're down by the creek, there's some up in the trees, and I look, there's a small tree about 12, 14 feet from us, and I'm looking directly at it, and here's one of these lights, and as soon as I look at it, the light goes out, and I close the blinds, and now I'm really freaked out because I'm nervous right now even telling you this. I'm scared, you know. But I open the blind back up and the light's back on. And it seems like when I look at it, the light goes off. And now I'm noticing these things are all around us. And we're on the creek bed. The bushes are moving in and out. But they're all basically the same size and glowing. Like I said, they're glowing from like the inside. So now we're scared. We've got the doors closed and the guns are loaded. And I'm thinking, well, I don't need a gun. I don't need a gun for my own people. You know what I mean? Not these things. So I'm like praying, like, oh, we're just up here to go fishing, you know, not bother anybody. And we started noticing this great big white light that was behind us when I opened the camper door. And it was huge with like a whipping tail. I mean, it was really odd, but it was the same type of a glow like the small lights. And it was whipping back and forth, and of course, you know, these other small lights around us, and oh, I'm afraid. I don't want to go outside the camper because I don't know what's really going on. And, of course, this goes on for a while. We're still watching these things. And then I tried taking pictures. The dogs were howling, making these weird noises. My video camera didn't work, and I couldn't get the electrics to work in the camper. So I was like, okay. So I tried taking still pictures, but they eventually all came out black. But I don't know. I can't remember how long after that, but it was like all of a sudden the whole camper lit up like you were in the Coliseum at a night game. It was just
wow.
like daylight. And it was like, whoa, what was that? And I thought, oh, maybe it's a ranger coming down to check on us because we're camping down here. And I go and look through all the windows. There's no lights. There's no nothing. I go look out to the front of the camper. That big, huge mothership, that's the only thing I can describe it as, has now moved in front of us. And that's the only thing I can figure. It lit the whole camper up when it went over us.
to the light. And eventually it moved back behind us again, behind the back door. I watched it, watched it, watched it, and I was nervous. And then it shot these red, like, laser lights out to the other red ones that had landed on the other side of the valley. And it went beep, 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 like about a dozen times. All these small red ones with, you know, one came, then another one came, and another one came, and it came up underneath this thing. And it's like they went poof, and I don't know if they went in it or what, and that thing flew out of the valley. And all you could hear was the air, and it flew away. But those lights stayed around us the whole time until I finally went to sleep about 2:30 in the morning. And then, of course, the next night I couldn't leave because I told my wife, I said, maybe I was hallucinating or something. You know, we got up safe for the second night. We didn't see the big ship again. All we seen was like a cigar shaped with an orange glow on the front with port windows that flew over us with no engine noise, no noise whatsoever, like it had an engine, and went over us. And then, of course, the small red ones. And then that, now the next day I did pull the truck up and camp on top of the water on the reservoir side. And I lit a campfire, and that's when we seen the cigar-shaped one. But I actually walked over with my lantern half-lit, put it down, and walked the other 10 feet to look down the face of the dam. And those small globe lights were, again, down there at the face of the dam moving around. And then, of course, you know, I said, oh, I'm getting back in the camper now, locking the door again, you know. But that went on for hours. You know, and it's always bothered me, like, did something ever happen to us? You know, I mean, my wife was totally freaked out, and I never heard the dogs howl like that before. They making these weird noises like something, you know, wasn't really right. And then, but now you might think I'm crazy, because probably the last 6 months or so, I've been waking up like somebody's looking through my window in my backyard into the bedroom. And then a few times I've woken up where actually there's like three small of those gray alien guys that you see pictures of and all that. There's two small ones the same size and one's a little bit bigger standing, and they're always standing, the two little ones to the left of me and the bigger one to the right of me, and they always stand on my side of the bed, never the front of the bed when I wake up, never my over by my son's room, but they're always on that one side where I was waking up before, like they were watching me through my my bedroom window. But so that's my there's something out there.
Wow, John, you know, there is something out there, definitely. And you know, good on you, thanks for sharing. That's an incredible story. I can imagine right now the way the world is and how people are so, you know, there's a lot of believers out there, but there's got to be a lot more. And when it comes out into the professional world and you start talking about how this mothership came over and lit up the whole park and things like that, people are going to be like, oh, yeah, rolling their eyes. And it's unfortunate because your story is one of the most incredible stories I've heard right here in vivid detail. I'm so jealous that, you know, my brother and I share with our video cameras backing you up, my friend.
Oh, man, I wish I couldn't get my video camera wouldn't come on. And I tried even turning my interior lights on to the camper. Nothing would come on. No electrics at all during this time when all this was going on, you know. It's like the battery was drained in the video camera.
So, you know, I think there's a lot of missed opportunity of these incredible sightings that people share to the public out there. And just like John just said, there are powers that we have no idea what these aliens possess. And they could shut down a camera in a heartbeat or black you out or put you in a state of shock where you don't even have the mind to grab a camera. They have these techniques. That's why we're missing a lot of these incredible opportunities to prove that we're not alone. I just can't wait till somebody gets a video from within a ship, the whole abduction, from seeing the ship being beamed up or taken on, however it goes down, and then inside the ship. I think that might come one of these days. There's so many people out there with cell phones. One of them might just slip through the technology. Hey, John, thanks for calling in.
Hey, I appreciate it. Thank you, guys, and I appreciate your work you do, and I keep track of you guys all the time, and I appreciate everything you do. Thank you very much.
Hey, thank you, and thanks for sharing your story, John. And when you go on a camping trip, have your camera close. Let's get to the next caller. Thanks for waiting. We're going to go back to more callers from Los Angeles. Area code 310, you're live, Third Phase of the Moon. Tell us your name. Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Los Angeles, and this is my first time listening.
Hey, thanks for calling in. If you had any questions or anything, you're coming in kind of broken.
Oh, no, I don't have any questions at this time. First time listening.
Hey, well, welcome to the show, man. And we will be
thank
back
you.
Next week, Friday, again, 8 p.m. Los Angeles time and 11 p.m. New York time. And we will be taking calls from around the world. Appreciate you being a first-time listener. Let's get to, I think we're going to go to San Diego. Kelly, 619, you with us?
Yeah, hey, how's it going, Blake?
Hey, thanks. Doing good, man. A pretty incredible show. I think we've had, you know, over, you know, I got to at least 12 people calling in with UFO sightings and incredible stories from around the country and Canada. What's your thoughts?
Yeah, I've just been, me and the wife, she's been listening in the background for a while, and then we thought we'd call in because we're just kind of listening to some of the guys' questions that have been calling in. The one from, I believe, Chicago was asking about the bell-shaped UFO, if anything kind of similar to that. And that one that you did say that was like the Nazi bell was kind of correct. But also, they had one that, and the one landed in, that was, I think it was back in this, the 60s or 70s. It was in Kecksburg, Pennsylvania. The one that crashed into the forest down there, they said it was either like an acorn shape or a bell shape. That's the only other ones that I would know of. Then he had the other caller that was calling up that was talking
about. Hold on a
second.
Okay. Yeah, cool. Good questions. We still have Pete from Chicago. Are you there, Pete?
Yeah, I'm here.
And so Kelly just described, you know, an acorn-shaped UFO. Did it have that kind of resemblance?
You know what, Blake? I think you heard me wrong. It wasn't a bell shape. It was like a barrel shape, like a giant, like you know, like a barrel where, you know, they store like nuclear freaking stuff in there. I don't know, like a giant barrel. Yeah, something like a keg, like a huge like floating barrel. But it was crazy because I saw the whole like shape. It was just dark, so. Yeah, I think you just mistaked. I said barrel instead of bell.
Yeah,
barrel.
No problem. Yeah, I heard you right from the beginning that you did say barrel.
Oh, yeah.
And yeah, you know, I can only describe to what I have seen in the archive, and the most closest to it is like the cylindrical shape, but and then the bell, that the Hitler bell. But yeah, I've never seen a barrel shape.
It was really weird. It made absolutely no sound. And this was a little town called Fox Lake, a lot of lake area around there. And the movie theater I was by was actually right by a train track. And this was like almost like it was above the train track, but it had no sound, no lights at all. I always look in the sky no matter what time when I'm outside. And that's the only reason why I saw that. Other words, there was no lights coming off of it, no flashing, but I saw the just the shape going across the sky. It was just weird, very silent, too.
Yeah, absolutely. Barrel shape. We've had many UFO sightings and videos and photographs submitted to us, but it's amazing I've not come across a barrel sighting UFO or barrel shaped UFO. Kelly,
yeah,
you had another comment?
Yeah, just for him again, I've never seen like a barrel shape. The only thing came closer, like you say, would be the cigar shape, but that would be a little bit longer. Anyway, the other guy that was there that was talking, I can't remember what state he was from as well, he was saying that After a while, he would, you know, when he said he'd see stuff in the sky and it looked like numbers, you know, zeros and ones, to me, that'd be a binary code that would be like computer systems run off of it. That guy had seen some stuff like that. Also, the other one for Manitoba, and I was kind of going through some archives, and from the picture that you had, like, you know, the picture of his crash into the ice, and also the other one, he had a video of a guy, I mean, of some that had somebody had sent through that, you know, I guess it kind of shaped. But a lot of those ones, even though if you include the one that crashed and the one video that he had, is, you know, the one that's, I guess, in the sky that, you know, he had zoomed in, pretty good view of it. Both of them have got different shapes from Billy Meyer has got actually some of his archive videos or photos that he has, especially the one that kind of looks like a pyramidal shape. If you was to take a disc and the one picture that he has, if he was kind of like buried a little bit, if it was to be buried into the ice, kind of like that picture you've seen, I would say it kind of looks like more pyramidal shape on top of that one. And then the video, to me, that one looks like I would say, like, kind of what Billy Myers used to see as well.
Yeah, and underneath that disc-shaped object is not, it has kind of like a pyramid with a top cut off, but in this case, it's underneath the craft and inverted, but maybe the disc may be flipped, and what we're seeing is the bottom in that one leaked photo from Canada.
Yes.
That's
what I was thinking too. That it could have been flipped upside down, and that's what we're looking at as the bottom of the aircraft. Also, too, there was another one that I seen, you know, from another page or another site that I also tend to visit. Is there was a lady who claimed to have videotaped that UFO going down. Like she's filming it from her backyard, and there's some trees going across, and it looks like, I don't know, it could be like a meteor or something, but if it was the air, that's the reason why she started filming it, because it was kind of weird. But if you look at it, all of a sudden, right before it's like where you can't see it anymore, it looks like something shoots out the side of it and looked like it was an ejection pod or something. And this thing literally shoots out from the thing that's going down, and it like stops in the air, like midair, like looking to find out, I don't know, would say, if it was looking at it, like where the bigger craft is going down, if that was an ejection pod, and this thing flies off the whole opposite direction. I don't know if you came across that video or not.
You know, Kelly, I did come across that video, and we're like trying to find out the story behind it and get in contact with the lady who apparently shot it. There's a couple questions, just some things that come to mind when we were first watching it. And it is an interesting video, but imagine if you were to film, a Cessna airplane from a distance, and then as it's following it as it lands, and then fast forward the footage. You know, it looked a little fast forward to me to resemble maybe it's coming in at a high rate of speed, but maybe I'm wrong. But I'm, you know, if we could contact the lady and get her side of the story, then I think it's very compelling. Kelly, we got another caller, but what's your thought on that?
Yeah, I mean, again, like some of these videos, it'd be good to talk with the people, like, you know, like some of the rules that you have is, you know, make sure you're talking with the people and that, you know, you get permission to show the video, but also to hear their side of the story and, you know, what did they see, what was going on at the time. That would actually be pretty nice. Also, just that one thing real quick before we go to the next caller, I just wanted to say that the video one, too, about that cylindrical shape, cigar-shaped UFO going into the volcano. That always happens down there in Mexico, and the same famous volcano and stuff like that. There's also there's actually a physicist who claims that the reason why they're going through those volcanoes, and just like the sun, I've talked about this before, is that, you know, he's saying that like they're using those as jump gates, because if they have a weapon or a piece of machinery on there, they can, you know, shove, goes through it, what they call a singular, I can't explain it the way better he does, but what they're using those things, volcanoes and the sun, for jump gates to go to. That's his claim too, is, you know, they're using those things, jump gates to go through, I guess, you know, to get to where their next space in another part of the universe.
You know, absolutely, Kelly, imagine the power that these volcanoes hold major powers for who knows what. And we brought it up back in the day. I think we asked the question. We did a documentary called Are Volcanoes Portals for UFOs? And we put it out there.
That's, you know, 1984 crap.
Absolutely. You know, that's, hey, thanks for calling in, Claire. And, you know, it is concerning. And Canada seems like they have those bragging rights about disclosure. And they, you know, they want to, you know, share everything, transparency. And in this case, they're going against it. But it's weird that there's a lot of the U.S. UFO people that claim that they are the investigators are claiming that this thing, this whole thing's a hoax. But it just doesn't make any sense to me. Why hasn't
they're
the military
gonna claim
showed
that
us?
About everything? Every other thing is a weather balloon, for heaven's sake, and none of us buy into that.
But these guys are like apparently out there to promote that there is extraterrestrial existence. That's what gets me. That these guys
well,
are out
that's
there.
What they say. You know,
yeah,
big
but,
deal.
They,
they're lying. Ooh.
They want to
you know,
drop
what
this.
A big surprise. I'm just going to cover it up with a lie. I know one thing. I've seen so many things in my life. I could sit up here and help y'all take up half of one of your shows. On the other hand, honestly, I'm worried. I don't know who to talk to. It's like I don't really trust MUFON. There are so many different things that I've looked into where I would like to report some of the things that I've seen, witnessed personally, witnessed with groups of people, and am just really concerned about talking about those things.
Claire, we've been we've been doing this third phase of moon, you know, basically a phenomenon on its own for about 4 or 5 years now, and we're like a toddler. We've just got started. And what amazes us is that, you know, we've delved into what this whole UFO thing is about. And basically, they're a bunch of the old-timers. They've been around for 40 years. It's the same people over and over again. It's the same story over and over again. And MUFON has been already infiltrated. And maybe Bigelow's not in on
Absolutely.
It anymore. They're doing their job. But they basically don't follow up with the people that shot it. I think that's the most important thing. And a lot of people are out there for, you know, their own gain, and they're waiting to get the exclusives out. If you watch Third Phase of Moon, I think you've been seeing that we're always coming up with breaking news that's always on cutting.
Yes, it interests me very much what's going on. I wish I had found y'all earlier, but at least I'm on the bandwagon now. I'd also like to say to this gentleman, Steve, I have seen many clips of barrel-shaped UFOs that have a small, black, long window on them. It looks like it's a thing that would only fit, like, one being inside of it. And they're known to hang in areas for hours upon hours. They've been reported hanging in a basic area for up to, like, 5 hours. There's two that were compared to be absolutely identical. One was on the shoreline, and I'm sorry, I can't remember where either of these locations were, that was absolutely identical to one that hung over a neighborhood, a suburban neighborhood now, for about 4 hours.
Wow, Claire, it's been an incredible show. Thanks for joining us. See you next week. Call in next week, Claire. Thanks for calling in, everybody. Sorry we missed you getting to the calls. We want to thank Drew, Rick, John, Pete, Steve, Emmanuel, Third Phase of Moon, Blake Cousins. We'll see you again next time.